So what you want to do is cut this up into strips like this and just overlap a little like that. Tape up around this afterwards. Then start peeling this back. Line up where I'm gonna put it. I've got it back to front here, but the other shoe's got some shit on it. Roughly find out where I'm gonna put it. Maybe use one of the cards just to press it down. These gaps you'll have to get afterwards with the heat gun. And then the hard bit. Just slowly and carefully just pull them back off. See, when you've got just one piece, it's easier, because instead of when you're pulling it across with a big lump, then you get all, it sticks to everything else. This to just hold them down as you're peeling back. Just real slow. See, where's my knife? On a tight bit like this, if you just snip the edges, so it will take some of the slack out, so you can fold it over. And then just carry on through. It is hard, but just patience with this stuff. And once you've got it, the transfer paper off, you can reposition everything anyway, if there's a couple of bits off. All these gaps we can stick down with the heat gun after. You can use the card for this. Just real slow, takes a bit of time. You need one of these though, really. I don't know if I sent you one or not. That's what these are good for, these. And we'll forget about this bottom bit because I've got it on the wrong shoe, this, but bit by bloody bit. I'll get this one off and then I'll skip to the heat gun. Now with the heat gun, we don't want to be hitting it too hard. Yes. Alright. A short blast, heat it up slowly. Want to stretch it in. Sometimes you want to just hold it in until it cools. Maybe use a nail, sharp point it, gets it right in the corners. Everything's down. You don't want to leave anything unstuck. Oh, where's that big one? Definitely round where any of these stitching bits are, you just want to make sure that they're all poked in and stuck, because it will bleed under them. Yeah. See, now with bits like this, wait, I don't know where my bloody knife is. I'd cut right across there and stick this bit on here underneath on there. Get on. Shit. Oh. See, that's how that stretches. And then tape up around the edge, cover everything, if you're spraying, that is, if you're doing airbrushing. Then you will be same with these bits here, just cut across that line as best you can. I will be getting some scalpels in soon and stick these bits down underneath here. And then that's basically how you do it. And you may, as you're going along, if bits are up, just hit them with the heat gun, paint it, and that's it.